You gotta step out of the darkness. If you wanna see the light, you gotta learn you can't get it wrong. Hi, hello there. Thank you for joining me and welcome to my channel. My name is Ludia and I'm the founder of Writers and Spa Solutions. If you're new here, I want to invite you to hit that subscribe button below and become part of the channel. If you're a returning subscriber, thank you for being loyal and don't forget to share this video with your friends so that they can come and watch and learn a few things. So today I'm going to talk to you about how to become a virtual assistant with no experience. If you just heard about virtual assistants and you're wondering that you don't have the skills, you don't have experience, and now you don't know where to start, stick with me to the end so that you can learn how to get started. Thank you.
So the first step is to know who needs your services or who needs VA services and why they need those services. So in this case, the person who needs your services is a potential client, someone who might be interested in hiring you. And if you don't know anyone who might be interested in your services, the next thing that you should do is to create a list of businesses or possible businesses that you think might need an extra hand. Some of the businesses and individuals who usually hire virtual assistants include realtors, small business owners, coaches, entrepreneurs, consultants, speakers, and many others that you can think of. Those are the people who might need your services or might need a VA. Why do they need a VA? The reason why businesses, so those people that I mentioned, need a VA because they need an extra hand, and sometimes because they have a lot on their hands and in their hands and they don't have time to do that, and sometimes because they need extra time to focus on other things, and sometimes some need an extra hand or need a VA simply because they don't know how to do a certain task. So that's where you come in. The next thing is to know what makes a great VA. So what makes a great VA? Why would someone want to hire you as a VA and maybe recommend you to someone else? Apart from their work experience, which I know right now you don't have, a client needs someone who has patience, is honest, is a good communicator, professional, organized, reliable, and a quick learner. So in terms of a quick learner, you need to be someone who, when shown something, is quick to learn and take it to the next level. Not that clients don't want someone that they'll be spending lots of hours explaining things, because time is money. So if you waste a lot of that, the client could be losing a lot. And now we come to our actual topic. How to become a virtual assistant with no experience. You don't have experience, you don't know where to start. The first thing to do is to pick a niche. When you pick a niche, the first thing that you should do when you're picking a niche is to list down the 5 skills that you have. This should be things that you can do without being followed up or without needing someone's help. Things you can do continuously without getting bored. They could be things that you learned at school, things that you know naturally. Think about those things and find out if you can do them online. For example, if you did graphic design in college, you could become a graphic VA specialist to your clients. If you are good in bookkeeping, you could offer that service to small business owners. If you're good at selling properties, you could be a real estate VA to realtors. If you're a writer, you can help expert bloggers to write and edit and post blog content on their websites because they're too busy or they don't have time for that. Customer service. If you did that course in school or if you learned customer service in school, you can use that as your skill to offer to your clients. So those are some of the things that you should be thinking about when you're thinking to start your virtual assistant business. And once you realize the skills that you have, now it's time to pick a niche where you want to focus in. For example, you've realized you're good in graphic design, so you want to focus on specifically people are looking for graphic designers, it could be that you love the environment and you want to work with people and you want to be in the environment niche. So you might be looking for people working in the environment niche or people who are doing environmental things and then offer that service to them. So it's all about identifying what you love and what you can. The next step is to get training. Now that you've identified your skills, you have picked your niche, the next step is to expand your territories. The fact that you learned that skill in school doesn't mean that you can offer everything that a client is looking for. You don't know everything that clients are looking for online because it's kind of different. It's not that the same. It could be the same, but not completely. So you need to expand those territories, learn more about the skill that you already have, find out what else you should know about that skill. What else does a client need a customer service to do? What else does a client need a graphic designer to do? Make Google your friends. Go to, if you can't afford training, you can't afford any course, you should go to YouTube, watch several videos, and understand a little bit more about what you want to offer or about the services that you want to offer to your clients.
Looking for someone to train you,
I'll share my link below. I'll share my VA training link so that you can click on that link. The next step, now that you have picked your niche, decided on the skills that you have and something that you want to offer, the next step is to decide your rate. Before you decide the rate that you want to charge your clients, you need to know the standard rate or what other VAs are charging so that you don't overcharge or undercharge yourself. So most of the time, clients, when there are some clients, not all, there are some will, once they realize that you're new to this industry, they are going to underpay you. So make sure you ask around and know what other VAs are charging or what will be a good rate for the services that you want to offer. You might want to charge hourly or per project based on what works for you, because what works for me might not work for you. So I'll decide what works for you. And the next step is to create a service page for a website. If you don't have money to purchase a domain and create a full website, a self-hosted website, you can go to wordpress.com and create a subdomain where you can be uploading your samples so that you can share with your potential clients every time they ask to see your work. You're wondering that you haven't worked with someone and you don't have samples to showcase. For example, if you're a graphic designer, you can be creating those graphics in Canva and then you upload them to your website so that when clients come and ask, you share with them, you tell them this is my work and this is what I'm capable of doing. Maybe you can do a paid test. And if you can't also create a WordPress subdomain, a website from a WordPress subdomain, you can also go to Canva. Canva has that feature of a website. Then you create a simple website where you can share all your things. And if that doesn't work also, you can go to Facebook, create a page where you can share all about yourself or all about that you offer. So it doesn't have to be expensive. The next thing that you should do is to join groups where your ideal clients hang out. The first thing that you mentioned is to pick a niche. Now it's time to follow your potential clients where they hang out. For instance, if your potential clients are realtors, where do they spend most of their time? Is it on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube or Instagram? So find out where your clients spend most of their time, follow them there, and start providing value. By this, I don't mean you go to other VA groups, because in those VA groups where VAs hang out, you are likely to get clients, but those clients are not going to pay you well, because most of that jobs are from VAs who are looking to outsource. So find your potential clients and work with them directly, or start providing value before they can hire you. They want to see something that they will be getting from you. Congratulations, now you are a VA. The next thing is to start looking for jobs. So there are so many places where you can find VA jobs, and among them, they include Upwork.com, Fiverr.com, PeoplePerHour.com. And another good option of finding jobs is called pitching. Called pitching means you send a proposal to clients who haven't shown any interest in your services or in any VA services. You just go to Google, search for your potential clients who you think may need your services, and then send them a message. Hey, I'm a VA. This is what I do. I'm checking out if you would be interested in hiring me. Once you've done all that, the next thing that you need to do is to keep marketing your services. Keep marketing yourself. It doesn't stop there. Spread the word. Tell everyone. Tell your friends. Tell your family. Share on social media. If you have an email list, keep sharing what you do, the services, the rates, and you'll finally land your potential client. Thank you for watching. And don't forget to post your comments below or your questions. I'll be responding. And if you need training, you can click the link below to register. And the first five people will be commenting on this video. I'm going to give you my training at the rate that I'm going to post in the description. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.